Hello there, and welcome to the Lharbur Show. My name is Luke Harbur. I am your guest, and I'm your guest. I'm your host. And today's guest, we have the incredible Mrs. Kearney, who was my drama teacher in middle school. Mrs. Kearney, how are you doing today?
Oh, Luke, it seems like just yesterday, and yet so long ago, all at the same time.
Not agree more with you.
I will never forget seeing you walk down the hall. Oh, you had auditioned for the fall play.
Yes.
What year were you in middle? Middle school.
Oh my God. I started middle school in
2010. 2010?
Yeah.
Okay. You had auditioned and you were amazing.
Oh, that's very
and
sweet.
You were
Thank
walking
you.
Down the hall. I think I was on hall duty standing there and you said hello. And I thought you were a transfer, like you were in eighth or ninth grade or something.
Nah.
I said, well, Luke, where, you know, from what school did you come to here at California Trail? You said, Pleasant Ridge. Elementary. Oh, was like, you're not that young, no way, because you were so mega talented.
Well,
and I'm absolutely thrilled to know you now.
Thank you.
As a former student.
Yes.
And as we have this people kind of friendship as opposed to teacher student.
It's really nice.
And
hey, make sure that you keep these incredible educators in your life. Very, very
thank
important.
You. Thank
well, Mrs.
you.
Mrs. Kearney, are you ready to do the first segment of the Lharbur Show, Harbur Hot Takes?
I am so ready.
Amazing.
Okay.
Mrs. Kearney has been given three topics, and she is going to just get one sentence to share her thoughts on each topic. So, number one, Mrs. Kearney, what are your thoughts on dieting?
Simply eat well, exercise, be healthy, rather than dieting.
Great! Nice! Very good. Topic number two, what are your thoughts on taxes? One sentence.
Taxes are absolutely necessary for maintaining vital needs of our society and cities, but the tax laws giving breaks to the 1% really chaps my heart.
Yeah, very good. And topic number three for Harbur Hot Takes. What are your thoughts on technology?
Technology. Love it when it works, really hate it when it doesn't, and it can be overwhelming.
Yes.
Notice all of my commas.
All the commas
I'm
were very,
very,
very solid.
Yes.
It was very good.
Yes.
Up top. So now we are on to the second segment of the Lharbur Show, which is Harbur Talk. Mrs. Kearney and I have three topics that we're going to talk about in a 9-minute period. And with those three topics, we can talk about them as long as we want to or as short as we want to. So Mrs. Kearney, are you ready to do this?
You betcha.
Amazing. So let's start the timer in 3, 2, 1. So something that I really want to talk to you about today is the taboo of retirement. And for me, I see this as taboo because as a young person, I don't really have a lot of money. Like, I don't know what it even means to think about retiring. Like, I don't know. What are your thoughts on that?
Well, you know, when I was your age, I didn't either.
Right.
I really wasn't thinking retirement at all. But I did think savings. My parents raised me to always put, you always just kept money in the bank. And that was a wonderful trait that they taught me and that they modeled for me.
Right.
Well, then as you grow older and you actually realize, perhaps I want to retire in X number of years, then if you haven't done the savings or the financial things that you need to do to make that happen, it can be kind of very difficult.
Well, right. And I just have noticed with, you know, a lot of my friends have student loans. A lot of my friends have big car payments. All of that has become taboo because they can't really make a savings. So I just think for even some people that, because I mean, to call my own side out, I don't have a car payment. I don't have student loans. But for people who do, you know, How do you navigate that kind of conversation? How do you navigate that kind of thing?
And, you know, I am so fortunate that our daughters were able to, because of our savings and my parents' savings, they were able to go through college without student loans as well, mm-hmm. which is huge, huge.
It is really huge.
I think it is changing. The whole retirement vision, I think, is changing because of young people having to accrue that kind of debt.
See, right.
That is, yeah. That was not necessarily of my generation.
Right.
And I think, boy, having the right people in your corner, just a good financial person.
Yeah.
The gal that works with us is amazing, and she has just guided us through so many, she guided us through retirement. And that was just, we got her in our corner, and yeah. that was kind of a happenstance thing. But it really is never too young to have people that yeah. know what they're doing.
And that's what I'm thinking.
To
like,
help you out.
When do you start? Like, when do you start actually thinking about your finances long term in that
I think
way?
You,
just as soon as
I
you
think
can,
as soon as,
soon as you
can.
Get a job?
I do. I really do.
Okay.
And the perspective you'll have about those financial, that financial history will mm-hmm. change as you, I'm sorry, financial future, not history.
Yeah.
That will change as you change and get older and evolve and mature and all of that.
Right.
But it's never too early to start talking about it.
No, that's very good. Well, and then let's go into segue into the next topic, which is the taboo topic of sex education.
Now, sex education.
Mrs. Kearney, why do you think this is a taboo topic,
and I
in
think
your opinion?
The fact that it is a taboo topic is the problem. That's the whole problem.
Right. It
shouldn't be.
Right.
And you could trace back to the history of the world and Victorianism and Puritan. You can trace.
People have been having sex for millennia.
But
let me tell you.
They've not talked about it for millennia.
And it's just incredible that sex and being educated about it has been stigmatized, because in order to practice safe sex, in order to communicate well with anyone regarding consent, for God's sake,
yes.
especially within
yes.
high school and in college,
yes.
when you don't have that groundwork of good sex education, it's so difficult for men and women both to navigate
Absolutely.
That time
Absolutely.
In your life.
Absolutely. I think it is improving. Mm-hmm. For example, in my household, sex education was, don't do it. That
literally
was,
don't
that
have
was
sex
just,
is what your
that
parents
was basically
said?
I guess when I got married, I would magically just suddenly
have the stork is gonna be there with the baby that has a perfect gene match
exactly.
of you and your husband Tom, you know, it's all gonna work
that's
out.
That's kind of the way it was. Ugh. And it wasn't until when I was way older, much more of an adult, that I really realized how negatively it impacted me that I couldn't talk about sex within, you know, I did what all the other people my age did. You talked to your friends.
See, right. You didn't. And if you tried to talk to your family, maybe that would be difficult. You know, it depends on where you went household to household. So even if you had parents who wouldn't talk about it, if you didn't have friends who talk about it, then the default would be the public education, right? And if that's bad, then what do you do?
And if parents don't want to talk about it and they want the school to take care of it, but then people are intimidated by, I don't want sex taught in the schools. Well, then what are you going to do? Somebody has got to teach
and isn't it,
our kids.
Isn't it ironic that it's the parents saying that? The parents who have had sex to have children.
children.
I can't, like, it amazes me. I, you know, no matter what your background, everyone deserves to have their thought and their opinion. It's important to listen to each other.
Absolutely.
But when it comes to not having, like, proper sex education or proper, slightly uncomfortable conversation regarding really hard conversations,
right,
it makes me frustrated. I don't know about you, but it gets
me
really frustrated.
And I think, again, if it were not taboo and a kid comes home and asks a question, you say, yeah, let's, you know, if the kid comes home and says, I found this in the street. What is it? Oh, it's a flash drive, honey. What's a flash drive? You use it with a computer to get information. Oh, right. Okay. Thanks. I found this in the street, Mom. What is it? That's a used condom, Bobby. Yeah. What's that for? Well, that is for a man to put over his penis when he has, if he has sex and they don't want to create children through that act. Right. Oh, okay, thanks, Mom.
Oh, okay, thanks, Mom. Right, it can be an in-passing conversation.
It would be that way, but boy, if that had happened in my day, it would not have been discussed like that. So right. I do think it's getting better.
Right.
But the fact that we even still think of sex education as a taboo topic is the problem.
Beautifully said. And last but not least, this is what you want to talk about today.
Yes.
Mrs. Kearney, please tell me why you feel soap operas are taboo. What's going on there?
What is going on there? Soap operas are a valid art form and entertainment form.
Okay.
All right?
Uh-huh.
The actors that work on these soap operas?
Yes.
Holy cow. There are actors that have come from other medium.
Right.
And like, you know, they did a primetime show or whatever, and they come and do a soap and they are blown away because they have to tape one day 30 pages of lines. The next day they have 15 pages of lines. Then the next day they have did it, as opposed to they once a week do a show and they rehearse and rehearse and rehearse. Soap operas, you get there, you do a walkthrough, you tape. You don't stop. You have to know your lines. It is a difficult, difficult medium. And people diss it.
Well, like, right. So honestly, like, I was going to say, I until you've told me this perspective, I have dissed it, and that's wrong.
Don't you be dissing those
soap
operas.
I'm not going to diss no soap operas from now on, now that you've... Because this is the kind of perspective that's needed for this kind of medium. I never got it. It was taboo to me because it's like, what am I actually getting out of this storyline?
If you would say, I watch soap operas, people would... They'd eschew you and put their nose up.
They would shame you.
Watch those. I have loved watching soap operas since my late 20s. Uh-huh. And it was just like I got hooked on the stories, you know.
Yeah.
Then when I was teaching, it became my mental junk food. I would come home at the end of the teaching day, and my brain was fried. And it was just, I'll relax into these problems that really don't exist. And and I will just let it all go. And my daughters, this is fun for me. My daughters grew up as little girls and young women, junior high, high school, knowing I watched the shows. Uh-huh. And so we would chat about it. We'd joke about it.
Uh-huh.
And it created a kind of a fun bond in our relationship.
Uh-huh.
My older daughter, who is now 37, sent me, she lives in New Mexico. She texted me a while back and said, did you know that Phyllis is back, that Michelle Stafford is back to playing Phyllis on The Young and the Restless? And I was like, yes,
how did you know?
She said, I saw it on a Soap Opera Digest magazine at the grocery store. And so we went back and forth with texts of, yes, and so-and-so is also still there. And, well, so what about the character of Michael? Oh, Michael's married to Lauren. Oh, Lauren, she's a babe. I know, she's gorgeous.
So at the end of the day, that show has created a very legitimate connection between
Absolutely.
You and your children. That's a beautiful thing.
So don't be dissing the soaps.
Don't be dissing
the
soaps.
They are very difficult to act in and to navigate. And they've got some stuff to offer, man. They can touch your heart and soul.
Beautifully said. Mrs. Kearney, you have been nothing but a joy and a pleasure. Thank you for coming on today.
My pleasure. Absolutely. I own the total pleasure of this.
Amazing. You're the best. Mrs. Kearney, are you ready for the end slate?
Oh, I am. I am.
Wonderful. Ready?
I've been looking forward to this.
Pause, play, try to be kind, and keep making a difference. We'll see you guys soon.
Bye.
Down low.
Oh yeah.
To the side.
Woo!